Hello everyone, here in this video we are going to learn about difference of two squares by using algebraic third identity. In the last video we have started this chapter. Few more questions we can do it in this present video. 144 b power 4 c minus c. We have to write the number in terms of square, and 144 can make 12 square and b power 4. In this question, term 1 and term 2 both are having the common variable c. So we can take this c out, remaining we can have 144 b power 4. C is outside, minus this c is out, we can write 1. Now this 144 can be written in the form of 12 square. B power 4 can be written b square whole square, minus 1 can be written 1 square. See, this 12 and b square, they both are having power 2 commonly. So we can write 12 and this b square, they both have power 2 minus 1 square. Now this question is written in the form of a square minus b square. So whenever you can see first number square minus second number square, we can make two brackets, and in the first place we can write first number. In the bracket, first number is 12b square. So we can also write 12b square, 12b square. Second number is 1 square, 1, 1. Because of this difference, we can say 1 is plus, 1 is minus. This is the answer for this question. And number 2, 12 m power 5 n power 7 minus 27 m cube and n cube. Here the numbers are not in the square form. We have to rearrange. Number 12 and 27, they both are having a common multiple 3. So we can take out 3 outside. Then this is m power 5 and this is m power 3. We can take the least power, which is m power 3 commonly. N power 7 and n power 3, take least one commonly. Now we have to write the remaining numbers. When 3 is out, how many 3 can make 12? 4. So 4 here. Out of m power 5, we took m power 3 out. So m power 2 will be remaining. Here n power 7, but we took 3 outside, so 4 will be remaining. Minus, how many 3 can make 27? 9. This m power 3 is out, n power 3 is also out. Now we have to rearrange this m cube and n cube. We can write m and n, they both are having power 3, or we can write separately also. Here this number 4m square n power 4 minus 9 can be written. This 4 is 2 square, then m square, n power 4 is n square whole square, minus 9 is 3 square. Now we can write this 2m n square. All these 3 terms are having common power 2, 2, 2. So that we can write all this number in one bracket, 2, m, n square. They all are having power 2 minus 3 square. Now we wrote this condition in the form of a square minus b square, so that we can draw two brackets first. And in the first bracket, the first term, which is 2, m, n square, 2, m, n square. Same 2 m n square. Next one, 3 square, we have 1 3 here, another 3 here. We have different sign, so 1 is plus, 1 is minus. In this first term we have square form, but still n is having power 2, that's why we are writing power 2 here and there. Next question, which is 25 a square minus 16 a square b square. Here we can take a square has a common term then we are remaining with 25 minus 16 b square a square, 25 is 5 square, 16 is 4 square b square. Again 5 square, 4 and b, they both are having common power 2. This is in a square minus b square form. So we can make 2 bracket. First number is 5 square, so here 15, there 15. Second number is 4b square, so here 14b, there 14b. Because of this minus sign, 1 plus 1 minus. This is answer for this question. And the next one, 81 x power 7, y power 3 is a minus 100 x power 11, y is a. Here 81 and 100 is square numbers, we can rewrite. Before that, we have to concentrate the variable. So we can choose the least power outside. There is no power for y and z, which means it is having power 1. Now, x power 7, x power 11. I am taking the least power x power 7. Then y power 3 and y power 1, we can take y power 1. Z power 1, z power 1, we can take z. And remaining, number 81 is remaining. Out of x power 7, everything is out. Y power 3, we took y power 1 out. So y power 2 will be remaining. Z is out. Minus 100. X power 11 is there. Outside 7 is there. So we are balancing with 4. Then y power 1 is already out. Z also already out. So here, x power 7, y is a. In the bracket, 81 is 9 square y square minus 10 square x square whole square. X power 7 y z, 9 y, they both are having common power 2. 10 x square, they both are having common power 2 again. Now this term is written in the form of a square minus b square. So we can write a here also. Then the next term 10x square, we can replace it for b. 10x square, 10x square, 1 is plus, another 1 is minus. So this is the way to simplify when the common factor is given. By using this method, we can expand this bracket. Now we can do one more problem, which is question number 5. It's in the fraction 1 over 4 a square minus 1 over 9 b square. The numbers which is in the denominators are square. So we can say 1 by 4. 4 is having 2 square. So we can write like this. Half square is equal to 1 over 4 a square. Similarly, 1 by 9 we can say 1 over 3 whole square. And here the fraction half and the next variable a, they both are having power 2. Here 1 third b, they both have power 2 commonly. It is in the form of a square and b square form. Draw two brackets and first term is half a. Write it in both the brackets. And second term is 1 third b. Again write in both brackets. 1 is plus, 1 is minus. This is the answer. Thanks for watching this. In the next video, we can learn simplification in algebraic fraction. Thank you.